Cheers, guys. Thank you very much. Thank you. Not so much for these guys, but this is the first gig I've done in like 3.5 years or something, and this is a hell of a way to do a first gig back after that time. Thank you very much, honestly. Thank all of you for coming out to see us. Honestly, it means an awful lot. Right. We are, however, not majoring on being nice and congratulatory and all fucking cuddly. Let's get down to it like we mean it.
Wow.
Cheers, guys. Thank you. Same album. Let's keep it old school. Let's get it going. Come on. Down here as if I can fucking read without respect, son. But you guys, the guys at the back, sorry, you won't notice, but this one's fucking upside down. It ain't just me, right? Yeah, well, at least you know. This is really, really trying to come back. When the sure. Maybe you'll reject the idea, but you know, I'm wondering if we could do a wall of death for this one. Can we do that? Okay. By all means, don't tell your solicitor that I encouraged it, but I'm thinking you might enjoy it. It's got nothing to do with me. Ooh! Balletic wanker tough guys, well done. Well.
Yeah.
Right. So, many of you probably just don't give a shit. Booze and metal and all that, and there's nothing wrong with that. But some of you may give a shit and or have noticed. One of my best mates and my partner in crime isn't here tonight. We think you probably knew in advance that that was going to be the case, but I have to say something just to explain why. There we were, having recorded what we thought was a good album. It's up to you if you agree or not, but we thought it was a good album. And then apparently the world got turned into a bin fire on stilts and everything went fucking wrong for ages. I think we know why. As a result of that, two things happened. One, some of the stuff Mick's been doing, like producing and that, took off so much, he can't afford to leave the house anymore. And good, that's great. I'm really happy for my mate that happened. That's really cool. But it did leave us with a sense of kind of unfinished business about what could have been on the back of a very fucking good album. Again, my personal opinion, not necessarily yours, but there is shit that could have been on the back of that that we didn't get chance to do, and some people out there in the world didn't get chance to do with us. So okay, Mick couldn't be here. That's shit. It's not my choice. It's not what any of us chose, but it is the case. However, there was stuff that we'd all missed out on over a long time of being confined to our homes and everything. And we thought it was worth, if there were people out there in the world who were willing to give it a shot with us, we thought it was worth celebrating that album with a few gigs. So tonight genuinely was an experiment. Honestly, I would not be arrogant enough to presume you'd give a shit without Mick being here or whatever, but we thought it was worth a fucking go. Turns out, many people agree with us, so genuinely thank you for coming, and hopefully it won't necessarily be the last show we play. So I just didn't know until we did it whether people gave a shit. So that was why we said it might be. Because it could have been, but hopefully it won't be. But some friends of ours stepped into the breach, the Akupakian Voices boys, and fucking look at them. Just fucking look at that. Imagine being able to call on that kind of thing in your hour of need. So genuinely, respect, gentlemen. Thank you for coming and doing this with us. And we would love for it to be the case that they get a chance to do it again. But we'll see. But cheers, guys. It means a lot. Okay. I'm going to stop being touchy-feely. That's as close to emotional as you'll ever see me get. Otherwise, fuck off. Okay, so now we're going to take it back to 1914-18 war. No, it's not a bolt thrower cover. Oh yeah, apparently we can't tell you that we want stage divers. We're not allowed to say that. So I'm not going to say that. More stage divers, please. I didn't say that. The Royal Court Chain, the Corps of S, was killed 1 week before the end of World War I. Someone once said the bloodbath had the song Eaten. I wouldn't mind the royalties, but this was our equivalent. Sticking with the same album. And also, no one has ever mentioned to me that it's the motto of Birmingham. It's called Forward. He's dead now, but an uncle of mine got into that genealogy thing and he found a raft of our family, and on the piece of paper it said killed at Gallipoli. So yeah, in a weird way it's 100 years ago, but that's kind of personal. Prepare yourselves for the future, ladies and gentlemen. Hold your children close and pray for Birmingham! Ah.
Walking back to prison onto me. We're on the side of the demons.
Websites and stuff like that. One of the people I spoke to said to me, it's almost as if sometimes you're talking about things that people believe in and want to worship, but they're not sure how to do it. Words to that effect. I said, you know what? We've got a song about that. It's called Idol.
Ah!
guys. Thanks a lot.
How are we doing, Charlie Boys?
Right. Okay, so I did mention earlier that we did a new album a couple of years ago and didn't get a chance to play some of it. So we're gonna do a couple. I remember last time I was at a festival that Cradle of Filth were also on, and think what you like of him, but Danny's a witty chap. And he was saying, yeah, we got a new album, we're gonna play. I don't care if you like it, we're just gonna fucking play some. Fair play to the fella, he's got the right idea. However, hopefully, you may enjoy this. And also, of course, I get to do a massive Rob Halford impression, so, yeah. Just like a pig with cocks in his eyes. We are all libidinous.
I've been scrubbing and switched. Fill me up.
Thank you.
guys. Thank you. So we are now at the point where we lesser men, we would walk off the stage and undo all that shit and come back on all over again.
Rubbish, you are well aware of that shit, you've seen it before, so we'll just stay on and do two more songs. But we will endeavour to please the crowd with whatever appendages we have available. So, yeah. So I might forget to say it again, so now I'm going to take the chance to say thank you for coming out this evening. And fuck me, weren't Sight brilliant? I fucking watched the shit out of that from over there, that was fantastic. So, I don't know if they can hear me or see me or anything, but Mirai and the guys, that was spectacular. Thank you for coming back to the UK, guys. These people all agree with you. Fair play, guys. And thanks to Mythology for putting this gig on. And hopefully, we'll see what happens, but hopefully we might see you again at some point. So this really, really, really will be our last song. We're not fucking around, we're not doing encores, all of that shit. Really will be the last one. So thank you for coming out one last time. Thank you to all the fucking African Coffee Voices boys for playing with us. Thank you to... Mark and Jake for putting the gig on. Thanks for coming. Can you see the future? Because I can. If you want a picture of the future, imagine a boot stamping on a human face. Fire!